Hello. So I'm first going to start applying my professional primer on my face just to have a little bit of a base going on. And once I'm finished with that, I'm going to add this Estee Lauder foundation in the color, I believe it's Bone, which is a little bit lighter than my skin tone just because I needed something to cover my blemishes and I definitely wanted to use a foundation that was a little bit lighter than my natural skin tone. So I'm just gonna add that a little bit on my face with a sponge and just work that in. Once I'm done, I'm then gonna grab my little palette that has all these different kind of face colors, which I got from like I think Walmart or so. And I'm just gonna take the white color with the sponge that it comes, but you'll see how this sponge, I do not like the way it applies it, so I definitely go back to using the regular sponge. But pretty much I'm just gonna be adding this onto my face just to make it a little bit whiter because skeletons are white, so definitely try to achieve that white look. And to set all of that, I'm going to be using this Revlon translucent powder that I picked up from Ulta. It does have a little bit of a white kind of color to it, so definitely will add more white to the face, which works really, really well. So pretty much any kind of powder will do that has like a white finish or maybe even a translucent powder. Just something to set it, that way it's easier to apply all the other products that I'll be using in this video. So once I'm done applying all that white, the powder to set my face, I'm then gonna go ahead and jump into my eyes, which is the focal point. So it is gonna take you quite some time. So take your time. That is a time consuming, but in the end, it is definitely worth the work. Okay, so for an eyeliner, you can use any eyeliner. I'm using the NYX liner in Jet Black or whatever it's called. And I'm pretty much just gonna line out my eyes. And I'm gonna use my eyebrows as a part of it just because I don't want. My eyebrows are really thick in general, and I just don't want them to look ridiculous. So I'm gonna try to blend them in as much as possible. But I have really dark brows, and that's inevitable. So there will be noticeable, which is, it is what it is, you know, I can't really do anything about it. But so just pretty much make a circle around your eyes, and that's gonna be pretty much it. So once I'm done outlining my eyes, I'm then gonna go ahead and start filling them in. And the first shadow I'm using is called Turned Up by NYX, which is, it's kind of like a teal kind of light bluish color. You can do any shades of blue. I personally went with this one just because I don't know, I just wanted to do this kind of shade to go with my look. Thank you. And once I'm done applying the blue color, I'm then going to be using this color called Ultraviolet from the NYX brand as well. And I'm just going to use the same brush that I was using earlier for the blue eyeshadow, and now I'm using it for the purple, and I'm just going to go ahead and put that on the rest of my eye. And once I'm done doing that, I'm then going to take my NYX black eyeliner pencil and go ahead and line out my nose. I'm going to be doing it, as you can see, this way in the video, but there are many different types of ways that you can do your nose. You can do it with a point. I just decided to do it with 2 points. I was kind of going off a picture that I was looking at, but it's totally up to you. Whatever you like, it's up to your liking. I'm going to be taking my NYX Jumbo Pencil in the color Black Bean and just going to go ahead and fill in whatever I outlined for my nose, which these are amazing. They really come in handy and they really are very pigmented. So if you are looking for something like this to line out your nose, definitely pick one of these up. They are lifesavers. And I'm also going to go ahead and set that with a black eyeshadow. I'm going to go back to using my Makeup Geek shadow in the color Corrupt. I'm then going to go ahead and grab the black eyeliner pencil again, and I'm going to go ahead and draw the lines on my mouth that are supposed to be like the, as you could say, the teeth in a way. So yeah, just pretty much do a couple of lines on each side and bring it down a little bit and up a little bit, just so it's a little bit, so they're a little longer. I'm then going to go ahead and use the next color, which is a pink color. It's called Wild Orchid from NYX. And I'm going to go ahead and going to contour my face with this. Just pretty much put this around my face, give myself a little bit more color, and just really make everything really pop. I'm then going to take these jewels that I got from Michaels in different colors, and I'm going to go ahead and put these around my eyes. And to apply that, I'm going to be using some just lash glue, any kind of lash glue, to be honest. I just got whatever I had, which was a Duo. I didn't picture it, but for those of you who know what Duo lash glue is, that will definitely work.
I'm gonna go ahead on to the next eye, and I'm gonna be doing pretty much the exact same thing I did on the other eye. And once I'm all done with that, I'm then gonna go ahead and take this black eyeshadow from Makeup Geek in the color Corrupt. And I'm just pretty much gonna put that also in the hollows of my cheek to give myself a little bit more depth and definition, just to contour them out, just because it is a skeleton and you really wanna make those cheekbones pop. I'm then going to go ahead and get my Duo Lash Glue, and I'm going to be adding these jewels that I bought from Michaels, just one in specific. It's kind of like an oval with a pointy end. It's really pretty, and I'm going to put that on the center of my forehead. And I'm going to go back to my NYX black eyeliner pencil and just draw a design on my forehead. Now, mine did come out a little bit crooked. I kind of overthought of it, but in the end, it brought everything together. So, doesn't matter how you do it, just as long as you try your best. My first one came out better than my second one. So, everybody isn't perfect, but you guys get the idea. I'm then going to take some lash glue and I'm just going to put it at the ends of the designs that I did, and I'm going to be adding some clear rhinestones that I also got from Michaels. And I'm going to be using the NYX eyeliner pencil again just to draw the rest of my mouth out. I'm also going to draw a flower type design on my chin, just to add a little bit of more creativity. I'm then going to be taking the Duo Lash Glue again and putting it at the points of this design that I did and adding white crystal jewels that I got from Michaels. Then I'm going to go back with that NYX pink shadow that I used earlier, and I'm just going to fill in the design that I did just to add a little bit more color to it. I'm then going to be taking that purple shadow I used earlier as well and just adding that and putting that under the pink shadow that I used. And now I'm going to do a design on the side of my face. I kind of just wanted to keep it pretty simple since I have so much going on and I really wanted the eyes to be the focal point. So I'm just pretty much doing like sort of a fork type on the sides of my cheekbones. I'm then going to be taking some of that lash glue again and just adding that to the ends, and I'm going to be adding some clear jewels from Michaels. I'm then going to be taking this glitter stick that I got from NYX, which I didn't show. I'm really sorry. It's a teal color. You can get it from Ulta. They have all these different types of colors, but for this one, I just outlined the outer rim of the eye with this glitter stick. I'm then going to take some of this glitter adhesive that I got from Sally's, and I'm going to apply that inside my eye. So I'm going to be adding purple and blue glitter just to make everything pop a little bit more. I'm then going to take the jumbo pencil in the color Black Bean from NYX, and I'm going to put this on my waterline and also tight line. Then I'm going to be adding these false lashes. These are the Ardell Double Up number 206. And this is the end look.